Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So, I think you guys already saw this on the news that they are gonna release another guild raid units. Yeah, I know right, it's kinda... what? I mean, they keep releasing this, you know, guild raid units. Meanwhile, we cannot access that guild raid. I mean, there is no actual content on it. Well, I tried to enter that, I mean, I saw the map and things, but I cannot actually do anything there. So, I don't know. Maybe they want to release the units like first before they give the actual launch. But who knows? Okay, anyway, I'm gonna give my first impression review about this Viper Blitzkrieg Durumn. I don't know how to spell the name, but yeah. Well, I just call her as Durumn, whatever. So Thunder Element, the leader skill, 20% boost to attack, 60% boost to max HP, 30% boost to critical hit rate of Thunder types. Okay, usually boost critical damage boost BB gauge for 3 turns, and usually boost Thunder Elemental damage. So critical damage and Thunder Elemental damage, right? And 20% boost to all parameters of Thunder types and 15% damage reduction from Thunder Water types in guild raid. You know, this kind of leader skill is very good for mono Thunder squad. Well, this leader skill's, you know, damage boost for mono Thunder units against water enemies that is not immune to elemental weakness damage and critical damage is gonna be very, very good. So, just my small prediction. Well, I think, is the raid boss gonna be vulnerable to elemental weakness damage and critical damage? And based on this leader skill, they're gonna hit like really painful. I mean, if they are gonna make this leader skill super useful, and if you don't have this leader skill, it's gonna be very hard for you. They can make the raid boss hits very, very painful, and then maybe the boss HP is gonna be somewhere around 1 billion. 2 billion, 6 billion, 10 billion, maybe. Because it's not impossible for us players to do 100 millions of damage with critical and elemental weakness damage boost. So maybe they're gonna make a raid boss with something like that, just to make a good use of critical and elemental weakness damage buffs. Well, if that's so, that's actually pretty good. I mean, we can finally see the actual use of critical and elemental weakness damage outside of Frontier Hunter. Okay, the BB, 26 combo thunder attack on all foes, enormously boost thunder types critical hit rate 60%, and greatly boost thunder types attack defense 100% for 3 turns, adds probable great attack reduction effect to attack, 20% chance to reduce 30% attack for 3 turns, and boost max HP 20%. So attack down, Thunder attack defense, and critical hit rate. Alright, the SBB, 26 combo powerful thunder attack on all foes, 3 combo powerful attack on single foe, so double attack. Okay, double attack SBB, and enormously boost thunder types critical hit rate, boost thunder types attack defense 120% for 3 turns, and boost critical damage 75%, damage taken greatly boost BB gauge, and usually boost thunder elemental damage 150%. Okay, so double attack SPB, critical damage, and elemental weakness damage, and it's very high, the multiplier. So most likely, yes, I mean the raid boss gonna be vulnerable to elemental weakness and critical damage if they are actually trying to make these raid units super duper useful. However, you can actually still do the similar thing using Gregor. But if it's for mono thunder, if the leader is thunder unit, well, I think the damage should be better. But you still can use your Gregor as the leader, and you can pick Durumn friend, and you still can get similar damage output. But if it's not for mono thunder, well, at least this unit still can be good to use. I mean, for the double attack SBB, you can still use her for Frontier Hunter. Well, yes, they are gonna upgrade the Hunter rank into 100 really soon in Japan. So I think it will also come to global like in maybe usually 2-3 months, something around there. Ultimate Brave Burst. 29 combo massive thunder attack on all foes. And okay, the damage is really high. And 3 combo massive thunder attack on single foe. Okay, double attack. AoE single target. And critical damage 300%. Damage taken enormously boost BB gauge 50 BC and restore HP. Okay. Enormously boost thunder elemental damage 500% for 3 turns. Critical and elemental weakness damage. But no spark. Okay, I guess. Well, it's actually depend on the boss. If the boss is weak against elemental weakness damage boost and critical damage, then this unit gonna be awesome. If not, extra skill, one family, one army. Boost critical damage 100% and adds death ignoring effect to BBS BB for 3 turns and attack absorbs HP. Alright. Just an okay extra skill. The critical damage 100% is really good, by the way. Okay, and the SBS skill. 30% boost to max HP and attack. Okay, nice. Critical damage 70%, elemental damage 50%, raise attack cap 130,000, and DOT 400% to SBB. Nope. Enhances BB max HP 10% boost effect. So it will become max HP boost plus 30%. Okay, pretty good. Very high on BB actually. And enhances SBB's elemental damage 50% boost effect. Oh wow, so it will become 200% for Thunder unit. Okay, this is the highest one for Thunder unit. Enhances SBB's critical damage 50% boost effect, so it will be 125%. Okay, it's very high. It's very high. And at BC, HC drop rate 30% for 3 turns effect to BBS BB. Okay, so BC, HC power at the same time. Enhances leader skill's critical damage 100%. Really? Really? So it will become like 250% critical. Okay, so with this, you don't really need to use her UBB. Because 250%, and if you use another Durumn friend, it's already like 500% critical damage. And I don't think you need to use her UBB anymore for the critical damage. And the elemental weakness damage boost is also already very very high. So probably if you are using double Durumn leader combo, maybe you can use UBB that gives BB damage up, spark attack buff, somewhere around there, to get even more damage. Allows UBB effect to last for one more turn. Nope. So probably if I get the enhanced leader skill critical damage, 40, and enhanced SBB critical and elemental weakness damage, they are in total 70 and 25. It's already 95. So I cannot get the passive skill if I took those buffs. If your friend leader already have the elemental weakness damage and critical damage upgrades, maybe you can just get the passive skills after you get the enhanced leader skills critical damage. Yeah, maybe something like that. Or maybe just give up the elemental damage boost and get the enhances leader skill and SBB critical damage, that's already 70, and spend the last 30 to boost critical damage and boost elemental damage, or boost elemental damage and increase max attack cap into 130, or raise attack cap into 130,000, critical hit damage and 30% boost to max HP and attack, somewhere around there I think. Maybe that's gonna be good enough. Okay, so, well, you know, on Maxwell's era back then on the 6 stars, this kind of unit, godly. Yeah, very, very good. Way too OP. Because there are so many enemies that have vulnerability to elemental weakness damage and critical damage at the same time. Well, if they're gonna bring that back, I mean, on the guild raid battle, that's gonna be awesome actually. Okay, so overall, this unit is awesome if the raid boss on the guild raid is vulnerable to elemental weakness damage and critical damage. If not, well, you still can use this unit for your Frontier Hunter squad other than for the guild raid because of the high damage multiplier for the critical and elemental weakness damage boost. You can just use Mono Thunder for this and she will be able to give like really really good damage output. Well, I think this is kind of similar to the Thunder version of Kira. Well, I've made a video about the Omni Kira and he was awesome for Monolight unit. So I think this unit can be also very very awesome for Mono Thunder, just like Kira. Maybe slightly better. So maybe I'm just gonna try to summon her later when she's available in, I don't know, 10? 20? Just hopefully I can get her. Okay, so I think that's all for now guys. Thank you for watching. See you again next time. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't. Bye bye, Brave Frontier Global.